So there are days when, like today, it's pretty sunny, there's no rain, but you see a big puddle right around your storm drain. What's happening is ocean seawater is actually coming in through the pipes and up and out onto the street. So even if you don't see the water coming in from the side, it's because it's coming up and under from underneath.
A puddle of water in the street might not seem like a big deal, but this isn't rainwater. It's salty ocean water. And it's incredibly corrosive to cars, pipes, and infrastructure generally. It's called sunny day flooding, and it's a problem all along the East Coast, where the number of these floods has doubled in frequency since 2000.
Climate change has caused sea levels to rise, and with that, our stormwater infrastructure, which was built decades ago, is not behaving as intended. With rising seas, water can go up through storm drains and overflow onto streets.
The challenge is really the frequency. So even just in the past couple of decades, we've seen places that used to only flood a few times a year, now they're seeing flooding 20, 30, 40 days a year. And we know that that frequency is going to go up really quickly as sea levels rise. You hit these tipping points where all of a sudden, every high tide or a high tide every 3 weeks is above that threshold that you're worried about. When it happens that frequently, we start to worry because it's disrupting people's commutes to work. It's forcing school buses to operate on a different schedule because they can't get to certain neighborhoods at the time they need to get to. It's preventing customers from getting to businesses, right? If the entire parking lot is flooded, you're not going to get as many people coming in as you would have before. And so it goes from being something that was maybe a concern once a year to something that's a really disruptive weekly occurrence.
Mayuki, Catherine, and their team are trying to discover the extent of the problem in Beaufort and other North Carolina towns so these communities can better understand how to manage these floods.
And what we have come up with here for the town of Beaufort and some other towns in Carolina is to create a really cheap sensor that we can put in storm drains and get the data in real time. But it's hard to sometimes tell how far that water has traveled on the road, so we have a camera. So you don't have to drive through a salty lake. You can check our website and see if water is actually coming up through the drain.
Having that information will be very powerful. And I don't think we're the only community that's dealing with it all throughout the coast. So we can also partner with those communities. What have you done? What has been successful? What have you struggled with? So we don't always have to reinvent the wheel.
These are really, really important places. I get lots of questions about long-term futures of coastal communities. And the question I'll get is, well, what option do they have besides moving? You know, there's no way. The only thing they can do is move. And nobody ever says that to me about Miami. Our imaginations of what's possible are really big in some places and really small in others. The answers to this type of flooding are going to be different from place to place. So in some places, they might choose to invest in their stormwater infrastructure. It might also involve elevating some of the buildings that are most exposed. And in others, they might just say, you know, this stretch where we're really concerned about how often it's flooding, maybe the best use of that land is a park, right? A place where it can flood, the water can recede, and it's not going to put anyone in danger or put any buildings into any type of physical damage.
We know that our boardwalk, the substructure is starting to crumble a little bit, so we've got to be able to fix this. Can we work with UNC and the experts there and then determine when we repair the bulkhead, how do we do this in a way that will help protect our community?
The most important thing is that we're trying to preserve what the community values in the long term. And that means that people from outside of the community aren't going to know what's best.
We can do our part at a local level, but this is a national problem. This is a global problem as well. And we need the U.S. to be a national leader in reversing the effects of climate change.
Our ecosystem is becoming off balance. It is really beginning to talk back to us in a very different way. So we're going to have to listen to it. The more it's stressed, the more it stresses us.
Thanks, y'all, for watching this video. And if you want more where that came from, check out our channel, Sci NC. Stick around.